what I want to do is work through the slides here on the Bayes filter, getting us to how we come up with our new belief, okay? So this was just our definition before, that the belief is the probability about the current state, given everything, including the current measurement. So we're going to use the Bayes rule that we just showed that says we can swap that around by putting in the likelihood and the prior. And the prior is just XT without the ZT over here, right? That was our prediction about what XT was. And this is this likelihood model, right? This is just our sensor likelihood model. What's the likelihood of getting that value? All right. Well, our sensor independence that we talked about before says if you have the state XT, then none of this stuff matters, and it's just P of ZT given XT. That's sensor independence. All right, so here we are. So the next thing we can do is, remember we talked about this before, this notion of total probability. The way we do a prediction, okay, for any given XT, what we have to do is say, well, what's our prediction of all the possible XT minus 1s? And why are there many of them? Well, all the possible X's at T minus 1. If we take all the probability, okay, that we would, we sum up over all those possibilities, and here, you notice what we said was, what's the probability of going to XT from XT minus 1 times this probability of XT minus 1 summed up over all of those XT minus 1s? That will be the prediction. That will be the prior. But this value actually can get made much smaller because notice that it has this term and that term. Because remember, the Markovian property says that if we have XT minus 1 and we want to predict XT, all this other stuff doesn't matter except the action, right? So basically, if you give me where I thought I was before and what action you did, I can tell you about where I think I am now. And that's what this Markovian step is right there. One more time, flies up. Wow, beautiful. Okay, keep going. All right. Well, now actually we're pretty much done. And now everything is beautiful and color-coded. All right. We start here, right? This value right here, that's just our belief about all the X's at the last time step. So that's written here. So now we're already looking at a recursive algorithm, right? Because on the left-hand side, we have the belief of XT. On the right-hand side, we have the belief of XT minus 1. So this is an induction. Remember, we talked about tracking as induction. This is an induction formula that goes from your belief at T minus 1 to your belief at T. When you integrate or sum over all the possible XT minus 1s, these are your predictions before taking the measurement. So this is just like we did with the Kalman before. To make your predictions, what you do is you take your belief about where things were, you pump it through your dynamics, and you add it onto your uncertainty. And then what this is showing is to get our new belief, okay, we just multiply that by the likelihood of the measurement. Remember, it's not your probability of where you are given the measurement. It's how likely would this measurement have been if that had been the particular X. And then we can worry about this normalization later. That's how we get the belief at new time t. All